I was going to wait for a formal signing sometime in early January, but then I watched the news this morning and they were all saying, will he keep his promise? I said that the bill would be on my desk before Christmas, and you are holding me literally to that. I have some beautiful pens over here. I think I'm probably going to hand some of them to the press. Does the media, would any of the media like any of, oh, look at these camera guys. Many of you have worked very hard. Many of you have worked very, very fairly, and we really appreciate that. So here you go, folks. You want the box with it or not, huh?
I've never seen anything like that. Welcome back. That was the president giving out his signing pens to people who cover him. Anyway, President Trump spiked the football once more over the Republican tax overhaul. You saw him there. He didn't take many questions, instead offering the press, as you saw, his bill signing pens. They usually go to members of Congress. Anyway, the president has only held one formal press conference this year, but he's had many mishaps when it comes to talking to the press. Of course, let's watch him in action.
Regardless of recommendation, I was going to fire Comey. I said to myself, I said, you know, this Russia thing with Trump and Russia is a made-up story. I think there's blame on both sides, and I have no doubt about it, and you don't have any doubt about it either. And if you reported it accurately, you would say.
You call him sick and bad.
Look, you can figure it out yourself.
But you stand by that claim about him?
I don't stand by anything. I just, you can take it the way you want.
Earlier you said that President Obama never called the families of fallen soldiers. How can you make that claim?
I don't know if he did. No, no, no. I was told that he didn't often.
Why should Americans trust you when you accuse the information they receive of being fake when you're providing information?
Well, I don't know. I was given that information. I've seen that information around. And we had the most beautiful piece of chocolate cake that you've ever seen. We've just fired 59 missiles, all of which hit, by the way.
A highly personal presidency. Let's bring in tonight's Hardball Roundtable. Andy Carney's a White House reporter for Politico. Jonathan Allen's national political reporter for NBC News Digital. And Francesca Chambers is White House correspondent for the Daily Mail. Well, this is a group, as always, an important group. But I don't know what to make of that pen thing. Was he sort of working the camera guys against the print people, the pencil guys, or what? What was he doing there?
Sure, and he was in a great mood. He's off to Mar-a-Lago for a week. He has an actual victory. He is spiking football, not prematurely like he did over the House health care vote where he had this Rose Garden ceremony for nothing. He has an actual big legislative win to celebrate here. I think this is Trump in a good mood, acknowledging that he's reacting to what he's watching on television.
Some people. That is the most bulbous pen I've ever seen in my life.
Having fun in the Oval Office.
It's the biggest pen ever.
It's huge. Jonathan, I have to say, we can be tough on him, and we are, and proudly so, but I have to tell you, we give him a lot of attention. The idea that we don't give him attention is crazy. I mean, we cover this guy every night. I got a Trump watch the other show. How can he say I don't pay attention to the guy? He can't have it both ways. We do pay attention. It doesn't actually have to be positive attention, but he keeps on, we don't recognize him. The Rodney Dangerfield thing. We do give him respect. We just dislike a lot of what he's doing. That's all.
He thrives on the attention. He gets the attention. He knows how to get the attention, how to manipulate the media to focus only on him. And when he's not getting it, he gets upset and finds a new way to get attention from us. So, I think, as Andy said, he's in a good mood. This is Trump as most generous with the press. Have some pens. Do you want the box?
And some of you work very hard.
Just a personality, but I'm going to go to Francesca on this. Did you ever go to New York City? Lately, last couple of years, and you go around Times Square, you can walk there, you can walk into in the street. There's all those people walking around dressed up with paint all over them, like the Statue of Liberty, like these big, tall people on stilts, right? That's Trump. That's what he is. It's all a show. He's walking around on stilts with a Statue of Liberty hat on, with this weird makeup. It's like a performance art. It's street art. It's street performance. It's all about that. What we just saw, that's not a president of the United States behaving. That's some guy playing around with pens. Like what? Well, it's a performance.
He certainly knows what he's doing. So what you couldn't see after that is then he comes outside, and I was outside waiting for him, and all of us are waiting for him, hoping that he talks to the press. Because remember, he was supposed to have a press conference. He said he was going to have a press conference this week.
What does that mean, show up?
He said he was going to have a press conference this week. He didn't do that.
The White House backyard of the Truman balcony. That was supposed to be a press conference.
Right.
No,
and that didn't happen. And there was some sense that perhaps there would be an end of the year press conference today, which Obama used to do. That didn't happen. So we're all out on the south lawn of the White House like, this is the moment. He's going to stop and he's going to take questions from us. He keeps walking, goes, Merry Christmas, everybody. you know, just mouths it and then keeps walking. I mean, and the entire press corps is like, no, come back, no. Wow. You know, and he knew exactly what he was doing. He had it, they told us to come outside. We're all out there waiting.
Which is surprising. He usually takes, you know, it's actually pretty accessible in those moments where he's walking to and from.
Oh, he wants to be. He is accessible.
But he didn't yesterday either. We also thought maybe yesterday, but he didn't yesterday. He didn't today. He did so very disciplined yesterday. He talks about the tax cuts. He says, you know, yesterday was Walter Reed. I'm going to Walter Reed. I'm going to meet with the soldiers.
Okay, Annie, you report in Politico that behind closed doors, the president has lately been talking up the outside advisors who helped usher him into the White House, fueling speculation about new additions in 2018. Who are the old golden oldie buddies of his that are coming back?
The golden oldies are ones that never really go away, like Corey Lewandowski, who was fired as campaign manager but never lost his close bond with Trump. At a Christmas party at the White House for staffers, he name-checked Jason Miller, his former communications director, three times from the podium.
Wow.
David Urban a few times from the podium.
Urban is a smart guy, but he's a lobbyist. Does he want this job?
Well, he's Trump's top pick to be ambassador to Saudi Arabia, but people are talking about him about coming in if he doesn't get that. Larry Kudlow is being talked about as a potential replacement for
guys.
Gary Cohn.
They're smart people. These are not dummies.
The question is, this is like Trump's comfort food. These are the guys he trusts. These are the guys who are always
these
with
characters.
Him. These guys also have a lot of enemies. There are people who, if Corey Lewandowski gets very close to having a senior job in the West Wing, are going to do everything to block it.
I thought these guys caused him a lot of trouble along the way. Anyway, the roundtable's sticking with us.